Good morning. It is time for yet another hike. That's right, we're doing two in 1 week. I've come up here into the mountains, currently at Car's Lookout. That's right, there was a Lincoln bomber that in the 1950s crashed into Mount Superbus, which is the highest mountain in southeast Queensland. Can't really see that well today because it's very, very hazy, very smoky, because sadly in some of the surrounding regions we have been experiencing bushfires. Houses have been lost, people have lost their lives tragically, so that's very, very sad. But still, it's absolutely beautiful up here. I'm going to be doing the Condamine Gorge hike today. So if you see this dirt road down there, along this path here, I'm going to be hiking a bit over 15 k's all the way down into town. It's going to be longer than last time. I've made my backpack heavier. I've maxed out the weight to like 20 kilos, so it's going to be interesting. But on the plus note, we're up in the mountains, it's much cooler up here. The temperature's not meant to get above 24 today, so it's gonna be perfect compared to last time. Nice cool breeze. So far the flies don't seem to be too bad, but yeah, I'm gonna drive down there, take you on another adventure. 13 kilometers to Killarney from here, so it's gonna be definitely 15 kilometers going back to the town. Over there you can see Mount Superbus, and that pointy one there is Wilson's Peak. I really want to go hiking up Mount Superbus one day. I was going to do it once a few months back, but I got sick so I couldn't go, but rest assured we'll do that one of these days. There's plenty more hiking to do. We have arrived, Condamine River Road. This is the turnoff. So I'm going to be hiking from up here down into the town of Killarney. So the usual road goes this way, but I'm going to be turning onto this gravel road here, Condamine River Road, and hiking down into town. It's going to be at least 15 kilometers, if not more. And there's going to be lots of river crossings involved. I'm not sure on the exact number, but yeah, the water level should be lower than the last time I was here. You can drive through here, although it requires a four-wheel drive, which I did once. But yeah, nothing else to do but get walking. Wish me luck. All right, let's keep going. It is absolutely beautiful up here. And I will say, on the drive up here, I noticed it does look a lot greener and more lush up here. Still dry, but not as dry as down in the plains. It's quite a bit cooler being higher in elevation. I would guess we're at about 1,000 meters. A little bit chilly now. We'll warm up throughout the day, but it's not going to get that hot. So that's something that I'm liking. I would much prefer hiking in this weather compared to the heat last time. It'll make it a bit easier. My backpack is full to the brim. I brought two water bottles. I've brought some food this time so that we can stop and have some lunch. But yeah, nothing else to do but get walking 15 k's. We're a little bit over a week away from the Kokoda Legacy event now, and if anyone who is interested in donating, because I'm doing a bit of fundraising for Kokoda Legacy and the Kokoda Youth Foundation. Kokoda Legacy, Legacy Gold Coast is an organization. They help the families of veterans and soldiers who have either lost their lives or gotten injured in combat. 50% of the money goes there, and the other 50% goes to the Kokoda Youth Foundation, which basically they run youth programs on the Gold Coast doing the Kokoda Challenge. It's for teenagers aged 16 to 18. I was actually a former member of the Kokoda Youth Program in from 2017 to 2018, and they do some really great work with it involves weekly hikes and training up to do the Gokoda Challenge, 96 kilometers through the hinterland, and also eventually taking a trip over to Papua New Guinea to hike the real Gokoda Trail. So you get to do hiking, you get to learn a lot about the history, learn about, and it's really just good in terms of character forming and focusing on core values of courage, endurance, mateship, sacrifice. There's a lot of history to learn. It's too much to explain in this video, but yeah, 50% of the money from the fundraising will also go towards the Gokoda Youth Foundation. So yeah, I decided to sign up for the 30 kilometer Gokoda Legacy event. You don't have to fundraise for this one. It's individual registration. You don't have to fundraise, but I'm deciding to do it. So I have a link down in the description for anyone who wants to donate. Of course, there's no expectation or anything. It's if you have the money, if you want to, then feel free. It will be very much appreciated and it's going towards a good cause. So a bit over a week away from the event now. Hence why I'm getting some training in. It has been a long time since I've been doing hikes like I've been doing in the last week. Last time was 10Ks, today is 15, at least, if not more. And my backpack is, it is heavy. It must be 18 to 20 kilograms. I haven't weighed it, but it is heavy. Endurance is one of the core values as promoted by the Gokoda Youth Foundation as part of the Anzac spirit. So courage, endurance, mateship, sacrifice. That's what it's about. Yeah, it's so peaceful up here, just in between all these mountains. This has been on my to-do list since I moved out here, coming up on 1.5 years. In many ways, time seems to have flown in that time, but at the same time, it feels in other ways like I've lived up here always. Oh, doggo! Hello, doggo! Hello, doggo. Hello. 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 Hello, friend. Hello. 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 You have a friend. Ah. Whoa. Calm down. It's okay. It's okay. Sit. Sit. Down. Sit. 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 He's just happy, excited. Hello. Sit. Sit. Well, he has a collar, so obviously he's not a stray. Or wild dog. There are some wild dogs around. He's doing his own thing. Or is it she? I think it's she. Okay, well, must be from one of the houses around here. Alright, I guess he'll be my companion for the time being. We have the very start of the Condamine River here. Water level is quite low, somewhere this way must be where the source is. There will be quite a few river crossings coming up, and yeah, this dog seems to just be following me. I mean, she went a bit in there, so I mean, I'm gonna assume she knows her way around, and yeah, hopefully doesn't follow me too far. See, just up there, that's the lookout, car's lookout, where I started and was overlooking this entire area here. Yeah, a guy just stopped who lives up here and he has a few dogs of his own, but doesn't know who he belongs to. Probably is in one of the houses back that way because there's no more houses this way. So it must be somewhere up there where I first found us. After this grid, we're going to start heading into the Condamine River Gorge. It's properly down into the gorge now. And it says you're about to cross the Condamine 14 times. So 14 creek cross. I'm not going to walk all the way back, man. I cannot be bothered with that. So yeah, she's just still following. The only other option will be to drive back up and drop her there, I think. All right, well, the flies are horrendous, so I'm gonna have to keep the fly net on from now on. And yeah, we're heading now deep into the gorge. The dog is still following me, but Yeah, I have a solution. I was just on the radio. There's no mobile signal up here, so yeah, my mum did drop me at the top of the road up here, and she's actually visiting someone who lives up here further down the road. So yeah, perhaps then I'll be able to drop the dog back or something like that. Anyway, the dog will make her way back, I'm sure. But yeah, this is it, man. Down there is the Condamine. Must be from the flood last year. Given how dry it's been last few months, we're more or less almost in de facto drought at the moment. It's, yeah, very hard to imagine that just about a year ago, last year, I mean, we had an insane amount of rain. Whole area here is well in the flood zone. I will say, I really feel out in my element here. Like, this is just where I belong. I get that feeling a lot when I get deeper and deeper out into nature. Since a young age, I've always enjoyed going on hikes, just being out in nature, and it feels really great to be out here. Because yeah, for a few years, you know, as I got busy, you know, with school, work, uni, I kind of stopped hiking as often or going out as often, doing things like this. And yeah, what I really want to say is, if you have anything that you've been putting off, anything that you really want to do, whether it be going hiking more often or surfing or traveling or anything that you enjoy, don't wait, do it as soon as you can, because it's so easy to make excuses and say, oh, I don't have enough time, I'll do this once I'm finished with this start part of my life, or, and you just put it off and put it off and put it off. But it's very important from time to time to make the time to do something that you thoroughly enjoy, something that is relaxing, something that's exciting, something that's fun, adventurous, because it's so easy to get caught up with the boring, monotonous routine of daily life. And yeah, for me, hiking really is a way to get out, break that monotony. It re-centers me, it helps me refocus. And by doing things like this, whatever it is for you, it doesn't have to be hiking, it will allow you then in other aspects of your life, your working life or whatever, it will allow you to be much more productive, much more focused, get a lot more work done, and reduce stress. Stress is really the enemy here that we want to get rid of. We want to work. We want to work hard. We want to improve ourselves. We want to become the best version of ourselves. But we don't want to stress about it. We don't want to be high strung. We want to be centered. We want to be focused. And that's what this channel is about. One aspect of it is documenting my journey, self-improvement, growth. And the other aspect is just living life, doing what I really want to do. I've watched a lot of YouTube channels over the years that have inspired me. Some of them doing similar things like this, whether it be hiking or just traveling, going new places. I very much like to watch travel vloggers. And for a few years now, I've always had this idea. I've always thought, man, I would love to try it out myself. But for quite a while, I gaslit myself out of it, where I thought, oh, I don't know. I mean, do I really have it in me? I don't know. I lacked confidence. Maybe I just, I don't know, had fear of stepping into the unknown. We all have that to some degree. But yeah, just being willing to try something out. Like, I'm so glad that I've chosen to do this now. It's been on my mind for quite a while. And feels great. It's awesome. There's not much else to really add. So if you have a project you want to work on, or just something you want to do, something that's been bugging you or something that's been on your mind, just take the action, go out and do it. Take the first step, because once you take the first step, it's so much easier to build momentum, to keep moving forward and get to where you want to be. Once you take that first step, it's just taking that first step that can be damn difficult sometimes. So I'm grateful to be here, grateful to be vlogging this. I always thought, I always kept talking myself out of this, saying, oh, well, I don't really have much to say. I've always been more of an introverted person. I was a shy kid growing up, you know, social anxiety a bit, all of that. And yeah, that's my confidence, my ability to speak, articulate, be articulate, and has improved a lot over the years. And I'm very happy. Still have a way to go, but I'm happy with the progress that I'm making. Progress over time. And once again, a reason why I enjoy walking so much more than driving, because I have driven down this road once before, in my car. And I love walking because you really get to take in the landscape around you, because of course you can't go as fast, so you really get to take it all in more without rushing through. Like, nothing wrong with having a nice scenic drive, but I personally prefer walking. I mean, going back before the Industrial Revolution, before we had vehicles, of course you've had horseback for thousands of years. But even that compared to like a vehicle is much, much slower. So you would really be forced to take it all in. And very often, especially in day-to-day life, people would just walk places or go in horse-drawn carriage, which is much slower than vehicles. So people were really forced to take in the nature around them more. And I think a lot of the problems that we have in society, mental illness, depression, anxiety, could simply be solved by spending more time out here in nature, really connecting with the earth, connecting with the land itself. Because the fact is, no matter what belief system you might have, of course we all have different religious, philosophical beliefs, and that's all fine. There's certain commonalities that underlie it, and part of it, I think, is, yeah, just connecting with the earth, connecting with the land, being more in tune with it as opposed to working against it. Because the fact is, we can try and fight against nature all we want, but nature will always win. Anyway, we're coming up on the very first crossing here, so let's see how it is. It looks to be quite dry. That's the sign, first crossing. I don't think I will even have to remove my hiking shoes. I brought my Crocs once again, but nope, it doesn't look like it. Yeah, it is very, very shallow. When I came here last, there was much more water. Yeah, it would be very easy to drive through this from now onwards. You could probably, we'll see how the other crossings are, but you could probably drive through this with almost any car, apart from it's a bit unsteady, but yeah, no, definitely, I won't need to remove my shoes. Coming up on the second crossing now. This one looks to have been filled in. Some of the locals were not too happy about. This one seems to be one of them. Yeah, it's not very deep whatsoever. At this stage, I don't think I will have to even take these shoes off, which will be nice. Yeah, very shallow, too shallow for swimming. I will say, this dog really seems to know a way around, so I don't think there's going to be much problem. She probably follows many people who hike through here. All right, two creek crossings done. Beautiful. So this is what they did here. I will say, I think this was all gravel before. I have to say, I think I agree with the locals. This definitely does ruin the aesthetic, and yeah. They should have just left the road, honestly. 2 creek crossings down, 12 more to go. It's been a while since the last one, but just slowly trekking through here bit by bit. Alright, it is quite a bit later now, and yeah, it seems that while I was holding my camera, I accidentally filmed quite a lot, so my battery's only down to 8%. Just about to head over the third crossing now, so I won't be able to get much more footage. I wish I had extra batteries, but I don't. Yeah, so I met some locals and they got the dog. They're willing to drive the dog back up to the top. I won't be able to film anymore. The camera is about to die because of accidentally filming, so a bit disappointing, but anyway.
Travel on, there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar, come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.
Come on!
Alright, I'm back. Caravan hike is all done. I'm still pretty happy with the amount of stuff I got. Basically, as I continued walking into the gorge, it basically looked the same compared to what you already saw. You saw the first two creek crossings, so there was 12 more, so 14 in total. At the point where I dropped off, basically, I was halfway through the entire walk, about 8 kilometers in, and had another 8 to go. So 16 kilometers in total, this hike was. And you may be hearing outside, there is some rain. That's right, we're getting some proper rain this time. What you saw at the end of my last hike, where I got really excited, oh, look, pouring rain. Well, that stopped after 5 minutes and just blew over. But this is proper rain. Like, when I was halfway down the gorge, started like light drizzle and steadily got heavier until it now is like this. Nice, slow, steady rain. It was pouring a bit before, but now it's all nice. Now it's a nice steady rain. If this continues, man, this is great. This really, really is great. With all the fires and dry conditions we've been having, this is great. It's exactly what we need. So I was very happy when I saw that it was raining. One thing that didn't go so well, the one thing that I forgot was my rain jacket. I had it in my car ready to go just in case, because yeah, I looked at the forecast and it said possible showers. We do have rain. I am just, it's not as bad now, but yeah, well, I was just completely soaked, and man, I am freezing. I need to get changed and warmed up here. I do prefer this weather compared to the last hike, the boiling hot, dry conditions with the flies. As soon as the rain came, the flies went away, so that was nice. But yeah, I'm back on the block now. I've made it home safely. I wish I could have gotten some more footage showing you certain things, but apart from that, all good. Apart from that, I really, really enjoyed this hike. 16 kilometers down through the gorge. It would have been even a bit longer. It was a bit like to get into town, to get to my car, it would have been even longer. I saw the sign to the town. It said 3.5 Ks. The last hour walking, I just had enough. It was pouring rain. I was freezing. It was wind. And yeah, I just wanted to get on a nice. There was a few people that were driving past, waving at me, all of that. And then I got to the turnoff to get to the town center where I have my car parked so that I can drive, come back here. Saw that sign, I was like, oh damn, 3.5 K, that's gonna be at least another 40 minutes of walking through the pouring rain. I just had enough at that point as soon as I got out of the gorge. But luckily, someone was driving up that way. He stopped, the local guy, I'd never met him before. And yeah, he offered me a lift into the town, so I took it. So I saved myself some time, got back into town, and voila, here we are, we made it. It didn't go exactly according to plan, how I wanted it. I would have loved having my rain jacket, but yeah, I mean, I'm right now, it's, yeah, and I'm shivering a little bit, it's, clothes are wet, it's cold, so I'm just gonna get changed into something dry, warm up, and enjoy the rest of my day. I started hiking at 9:30 in the morning. Then when I was at the people's place, I stopped for probably a bit over an hour or so, and yeah, got back into town at 3:30. So 9:30 to 3:30, well, that's 6 hours. So I would say 4.5 hours walking time. It took me 4.5 hours to walk 16 kilometers. So that's a pretty decent pace. I'm happy with that. And that was with the heavy backpack. This heavy thing weighs 20 kilos. Boom. Anyway, I'm very happy. I'm not really that tired at all, to be honest. My feet do hurt because some water got in my shoes towards the end, and yeah, my feet hurt a bit, but apart from that, I feel fine. So I'll enjoy my evening, chill a bit, and yeah, I'll see you in the next video, whatever it be. It'll be a while probably before my next hiking one, but I'll still keep updated on dopamine fasting. Just a quick update on the dog. So the people that took the dog up to where I originally found it, they did manage to find the owners. The dog's name is Rosie, and she's actually on heat. That's why she was out and about running around, trying to find you know what. And yeah, basically ended up following me halfway down the gorge. But luckily she's back in good hands with the owner, and yeah, no harm done. It was a very good trek yesterday. Apart from that, make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Give the video a like. Let's get this channel growing, and I'll see you all in the next one. Ciao.